I really wanted the Vibraphone bars to move when they're being hit by the marbles on the Marble Machine X. This has caused a lot of design issues. These two notes are perfectly aligned right now, but if I change this note out towards a longer note that is more heavy, you will see that the heavier note is falling down a couple of millimeters. We really don't want that. Since I want to be able to play live concerts with the Marble Machine X, we need to be able to take notes off, put them back at another place, and very quickly adjust for the height. I have thought of seven different design solutions to fix this problem. Before I begin to build the solution that I really believe in, let me quickly show you the first six disregarded designs. So the first solution was to loosen this set screw on the back of this pivot and put a plate into the position you want and then tighten it again. Problem is, it's really hard to get it accurate and it's a nightmare to access the screws, and the set screws will eventually eat out the shaft and things will come loose. The second solution is this positive bar stop here. So the bar is now going up to the stop and all the plates are the same level. However, this doesn't move as easily because of this preload. So the marble can't get the plate to move. Say goodbye to the positive stop part. So my third idea was to add weight to the shorter bars. 389, add some weight. That's close enough. So you can see this plate is a little higher than this. If I add my weight, it's way down and they sit at the same height. But this creates more mass for the marble, so less beautiful movement of the higher notes. So solution number three, adding weight. Fourth solution, shims. If I want this to be higher, I'm just sliding these shims under there. So it's a fast adjustment, but these parts are loose and there's magnets. And when you play them, the shim starts to wander. No, not gonna do more loose parts. I want something better. So the fifth solution would be a non-concentric screw here. And this is a non-concentric screw demonstration. So when we adjust this set screw, this non-concentric plate will go up and down, causing this to go up and down when we rotate the screw. It's a lot of work to build it, and it's only easily accessible on the first note. Solution number five led me to solution number six. I thought maybe we put a non-concentric screw here. So then you can just alter this set screw down here and you will have perfect control. Only problem again is that it's really hard to access them from here. But I love the idea to be able to adjust the height with the set screw, and that led me to solution number seven. I'm going to weld together 11 of these with 11 of these. And to do that consistently, I'm aligning this edge to the back edge of the vise. And now I want to mount this at an angle. This angle is determined by the distance between the vibraphone bar, which is 55 millimeters center to center. And I want this little hole to end up exactly between the bars, which means from the center here, we have to swivel it out half of 55. And if I look from the top, I can just swivel this piece over until I see the line going straight through this opening. So the added pressure from these springs will prevent the bolt from rotate by itself. Plus, it looks cool. This is the most any music screaming assembly on the whole Marble Machine X. I just love this assembly so much. I'm spacing this block so it comes center under this arm. It looks a little bit too far to that side. I'm taking one of these thicker washers out and replacing it with two thin shim rings. Yeah, you can see that the bolt looks perfectly centered now. So this is gonna be washer party because I don't have as many stop collets. If I had the material or a lathe or something, I would of course not stack 1 million washers like this. But this is what I have at home and it does the job perfectly. So now the hole is lined up and this set screw gets a little indentation to bite into this shaft. I need to drill and tap in the end of the shafts to prevent these outer ones from sliding out. This screams potential disaster, doesn't it? I never break taps anymore. I have to fake break them to create the tension nowadays. This set screw is now obsolete. I can completely remove it because if you haven't guessed it, this is the new height adjustment. This is what I have dreamed of. So now I have to make the serious version of this stop plate. So I learned that you can grind a 45 degree angle in the joint and then the filler rod has somewhere to go. The height adjustment is ready. We can put the assembly back onto the machine and see if this works. Really, really excited. Wow, I am so happy about this. I have full control over the angle. Brilliant. Here comes a real test. Here's a note that is perfectly aligned, but then we're gonna play another song. So we're switching the short, lighter note to a longer, heavier note. Look what happens. These notes sit visibly too low. Then we take our tool, and with just a couple of turns, shoof, we're ready to play the next song with all notes aligned. Yes! And I'm totally free to use whatever spring steels I want. I can use the easiest ones for maximum movement when the marble hits them. And if they get a little fatigued over time, we just go in here and we give a little clockwise turn of the set screw. You can see how this plate is falling down, coming back up. So, seventh time the charm on this solution. It was a pure joy to build this today, from concept to execution in one day. So what I learned with this is to separate mechanical functions away from each other. So the spring steel does only the spring steel thingy and it's not in charge of the height, and the set screw is in charge of the height and does nothing else. I kind of simplify things by adding this function, and I'm not relying on this set screw that has to hold the shaft and that can maybe start to slip over time. So thanks to Dr. Phil, who was never happy about locking a rotational movement with a set screw. He said it might eat its way out eventually, and then we have 10,000 in the audience and one of these notes just drops down. These notes will not drop down, and as I just demonstrated, it's easy to change a note, adjust it for height and start to play the next song. Pure, pure joy today. I'm feeling so, so happy about this. So this is another good example of how complex this machine is and how much things we have to put in for it to actually perform. So this movement of the notes was crucial for me to make the whole machine come to life, to visualize the music being played, because the marbles are really hard to see. But when one note is pushed down, it's easy to see that. So when people see this on the live concerts and on the videos, they're not gonna think about the adjusting necessity, but you guys know. This was another bonus episode brought to you by the Wintergatan patrons and Wintergatan YouTube channel members who are funding this project and these videos. Thanks to your support, I'm able to share more aspects of my process with everyone. And as always, thanks to you for watching.